Hello students, welcome you all in this fifth video lecture of NSO, which is Science Olympiad for class 5. So today we are going to discuss a few questions of this chapter, which we call as chapter 5, pollution and climates, calamities. Okay. So let us start with question number 1. Question number 1 says that the rapid flow of snow down a hill or mountain slide is called what? Okay, so all of you have known, I think, that the rapid flow of snow down a hill or mountain is called as avalanche. Okay, now second question, question number 2. Question number 2 says that there were a large number of dead fish drifting towards the shore. Okay, now many dead birds with streaky black coating on feathers could also be seen there. So A or aunt dash might have occurred nearby. Okay, so you have to fill this with these options. So out of these 4 options, your answer will be oil spill. Okay, why oil spill? Because oil spill is the condition when mineral oil or petroleum oil being carried on a ship gets spilled in the sea due to some reason. Okay, now this caused death of aquatic organisms like fish. Okay, now oil gets coated on feathers of aquatic birds, making them unable to fly and regulate their body temperatures. This causes the death of the birds. So you can easily go for option C. Okay, now question number 3. Question number 3 says that select the group in which the odd one is encircled incorrectly. Okay, so you have to find out the odd one which is encircled incorrectly. So if you go through the 4 options, then out of the 4 options you will find out that option number C is encircled incorrectly. Why? Because you can see that electrostatic precipitator, you can say scrubber, and catalytic converter are installing devices used to reduce the release of harmful gases in the air. Okay, and refrigerator is a device which is artificially cooled to keep the food and drinks at low temperature. Okay, so you can go with option number C. Now question number 4 says that greenhouse gases cause global warming. Which one of the following are the greenhouse gases? So definitely, as you have known, that the CFC gases, CFCs means the chlorofluorocarbon, and the carbon dioxide are called as greenhouse gases. Now greenhouse gases make a layer around the earth and prevent the heat from escaping into the space. Now it causes the increase in global temperature, that is called as global warming. Okay. Okay, this is a very easy one and all of you have already known this. So let us move to the next question, which is question number 5. Question number 5 says that select the method that prevents soil erosion by water. Okay. So, 2 methods are there, that means you can go with option D, that both A and C. Okay, terrace farming and you can say embankments. Okay, so you can go with option number D. Okay, the next question, that is question number 6, says that select the correct statement regarding water pollution. Okay, so regarding water pollution, we have to choose the correct statement. So let me read the statements once. First one is that suspended impurities make water more transparent, causing death of submerged aquatic plants. Option B says that polluted water can cause diseases like, you can say, typhoid, cholera and diabetes. Option C says that water pollution increases dissolved oxygen level of water. And option D says that agricultural runoff pollutes water by adding pesticides and fertilizers into it. Okay, so your correct option or the correct statement is option number D. Okay. Okay. Now let us move to the next question, which is question number 7. Question number 7 says that, okay, in the previous question, why we have said option number D? Option number D because suspended impurities makes water less transparent. Okay, causing death of submerged aquatic plants. Okay, and you can say that diabetes is not a waterborne disease. It occurs due to high blood sugar level. And water pollution decreases dissolved oxygen level of water. Okay. So basically, the correct statement should be option number D. Now, question number 7 says that when oxides of nitrogen and sulfur react with water vapor in the air, they cause what? Four options are there. So out of these four options, you can go with option number C, which is acid rain. Okay. Because when oxides of nitrogen and sulfur react with water vapor present in the atmosphere, they form acids of nitrogen and sulfur. Okay, so definitely they form nitrogen dioxide and sulfur dioxide. Now these acids fall down with raindrops. This is called acid rain. It harms plants, animals as well as buildings. Okay. Now next question, which is question number 8. Question number 8 says that in an earthquake occurs, if an earthquake occurs, which one of the following you should do? If you are indoors, stay in and get under a desk or a table. Or if you are outdoors, stay away from trees and building. If you are on a beach, get into the sea, or both A and B. So definitely you can go for both A and B option, which is option number D. Okay. Now in question number 9, it is said that the given picture shows the terrace farming. It helps in which? We have done one question regarding terrace farming. So if you go through the four options, you can easily answer it. Your answer will be option number B. Option number B means that terrace farming slows down the speed of flowing water and thus it reduces soil erosion by water. Okay. Now let us move to the next question, which is question number 10. Question number 10 says that human carry out deforestation to provide space for buildings and farms. Now some also cut down trees to provide wood for furniture and paper manufacturing. Which one of the following would possibly result from the above activities? See, four options are there. Topsoil erosion may occur. Some animals may become extinct. There may arise a problem of global warming. And some possible sources of natural drugs to cure diseases may be lost. Okay. So if you go for the correct option or correct options, there may be more than one options are correct if you go through the options properly. So your correct options will be option number D. That means 1, 2, 3 and 4. All the things will happen. Okay. Now let us move to question number 11. Question number 11 says that which one of the following statement is correct? So let us read the statements first of all. Statement 1 or option A says that the layer below the crust is called mantle. Its upper part is made of molten rocks and the lower part consists of solid rocks. Option B says that the liquid that comes out of volcano is called magma. Option C says that based on the nature of eruption, volcanoes can be active, dormant or extinct. Or option number D says that the magnitude of tsunami is measured on Richter scale developed by Charles Richter in 1985. So your correct options will be option number C. Okay. The layer below the crust is called mantle and its upper part is made of solid rocks and the lower part consists of molten rocks. Okay, so this is the correct statement of option A. Now, the liquid that comes out of volcano is called lava. Okay, it is not called as magma. And Richter scale was measured by magnitude of earthquake was developed by Charles Richter in 1935, not 1985. Okay, now let us move to question number 12. Question number 12 says that which one of the following pair is wrongly classified? Okay, now positive effect of the environment and negative effect of the environment, it is given. Okay, so the wrong statement is, we only discuss the wrong statement here. So the wrong statement is option number A, because you can say incinerating rubbish in residential areas will have negative effect on the environment as it will release harmful gases in the air. Now covering opened dust bins left out in the open will have positive effect on the environment as will prevent the insects such as flies, mosquitoes, etc. Okay, from spreading diseases. So you can easily go for option A. Okay, now question number 13 says that Atul studied two groups of things as shown in the table below, that biodegradable and non-biodegradable thing. Biodegradable such as paper, meat, wood, and non-biodegradable such as ceramic cup, poly bag, steel rod. Okay, now he made the following inferences. Which one of the inferences is correct? That all non-biodegradable objects are soft, all living things are non-biodegradable, biodegradable objects come only from animals, or most things obtained from living organisms are biodegradable. So out of these four options, our correct answer should be option number D, that most things obtained from living organisms are biodegradable, because biodegradable waste is the waste that decomposes easily through the action of microorganisms and mixes with the soil. Okay, so basically these biodegradable things come from both plants and animals, such as paper, meat, wood, etc. Okay, now let us move to the next question, which is question number 14. Question number 14 says that which of the things listed below are non-biodegradable. So there are a list of six things: cotton t-shirt, glass cup, cotton gold necklace, okay, roasted chicken, debit card, and banana. So out of these, which one are non-biodegradable? Non-biodegradable means what? Non-biodegradable means that which doesn't mix with the soil easily. Okay. Basically, non-biodegradable wastes are the waste that doesn't decompose or takes a long time to decompose, such as you can say ceramic cup, poly bag, steel rod, etc. non-biodegradable. Okay, so here out of these options, glass cup, gold necklace, and debit card are non-biodegradable substances, as they can't be decomposed by microbes or microorganisms. Okay, next question is question number 15. It is said that the given options show the bacterial count, oxygen level, and the number of green plants and animals in the river near each of the towns A, B, C, and D. Which town is situated near the unpolluted river? Okay, so basically bacterial count, it is given, oxygen level, number of green plants, and number of animals. So if you find out these options, then you definitely go for option D. That means where waste is thrown in the river cause water pollution. In the most polluted river, you can say bacterial count will be high, as this bacteria will decompose the waste present in the water, and this will lead to low level of dissolved oxygen in the water, as oxygen is required for decomposition. Okay, so this will advisorily affect the number of green plants and the animals in the river. In an unpolluted river, the conditions are reversed. Okay, now the next question, which is question number 17, it says that we skip the question number 16. So let us first discuss question number 16, then we go for question number 17. So question number 16 says that refer to the given figure and select the correct option regarding sites X, Y, and Z. Three sites are there, X, Y, and Z. So the options are there: the amount of dissolved oxygen could be maximum at site Z, number of fish at site X will be more than at site Y, or site X has most poor quality of water, or both A and B. So your correct option should be number B, which is number of fish at site X will be more than site Y. Definitely, okay, because in site Y farms are there, towns are there. Okay, so definitely number of fishes are less than site X. Okay, now question number 17. Just have a look. Question number 17, this one. Question number 17 says a large area of forest was destroyed completely by a forest fire. Which one of the following statements holds true regarding it? Okay, so let us read the four options. That more soil will be eroded, as the soil is not protected by trees from wind and rain. Second option says that the land will have more fresh air, as there are lesser trees to take in oxygen. Option 3 says that wildlife will inhabit the cleared area because more space is available now. And option 4 says that levels of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere will increase and contribute to greenhouse effect. So the correct options, okay, or the true option or options are, you can go for option number B, which is 1 and 4. So option number 1 and option number 4, these are true. Okay. Option 1 and option 4, these are the true statements. Okay. Okay. Now let us move to the next part. Next part means question number 18 and 19, same statements is there or direction is there. It is said that this direction, that refer to the given word grid and answer the following question. So this is a word grid. Now question number 18 says that select the option that is not hidden in the given word grid. Okay, so if you find out the word grid, if you you can easily find out. So students, do this thing by yourself only. Okay, then you will fill these things because you have to find the word and then you have to solve. Okay. So question number 18, do it by yourself. Question number 19 says that the term used for dash can be found in the given word grid. So if you tally the four options and if you tally the word grid, then you can find out that question number option B, that means rain, which is acidic in nature, that means acid rain. Okay, this word you can find it in the word grid. So find out by yourself. So question number 18 and question number 19, you just do it by yourself. Okay, now let us discuss question number 20. Question number 20 says that scientists were studying two types of, you can say, hospital waste, X and Y, for their disposal and their effect on the environment. They plotted a graph showing the change in their quantities over time by time when dumped in an open field. Refer to the given graph and select the option that correctly signifies X and Y. Okay, now just you have to go through the graph properly first of all. It is a quantity versus time graph, X and Y graph is there. So your correct option should be option number B. Why option number B? Because according to the given graph, X is a biodegradable material because its quantity decreases over time, while Y is a non-biodegradable material as its quantity remains almost the same over time. Okay, so cotton balls and broken scalpels are should be your correct option. Okay, so that is all for this video, students. In the next video we will discuss another chapter, and keep practicing this type of questions, because only this type of questions will the same type of question will come in your Olympiad examination, and you have to prepare yourself properly. Okay, then we will meet in the next video with a new chapter. Okay, thank you everybody.